What's up, you guys? I wanted to talk about my sorority rush experience and just give you like a general overview of what rush is like and how I ended up picking mine. I am a Gamma Phi Beta at Miami University. We do like spring winter rush. We get back from winter break. The first 2 weekends of the spring semester are rush. A lot of schools, like Southern schools, will do sorority and fraternity rush the week before fall semester starts. This is just how it goes with mine, so I think it'll still give you a good overview even if our schools do it in a different format. You have 4 rounds. You have open house, you have philanthropy, sisterhood, and then pref round. And as the rounds go, the outfits become dressier. You start going to less chapters, but you see them for longer periods of time. First is open house. Ours was on the Friday and Saturday of the first weekend, and we saw every chapter. A lot of times you'll go visit their sorority house, but we don't have sorority houses, so we just go to academic classrooms for the first 3 rounds. You see each chapter for like 15-20 minutes, and when you go in each round, they'll be like chanting and dancing, and someone will pick you up, an active member, and some lingo, I guess. An active member is the people in the chapter that you're talking to, and the PNMs are you, so you're a potential new member, and you're in a rush group, which is usually by last name, I think, and you're monitored by like a rogue gamma, which is an active member that disaffiliates with your chapter for rush so that they can like help you out. Rogue gamma is there to like show you where to go for each round and give you advice if you need it. Open house, all of the PNMs wear the same t-shirt at my school. I actually did a what I wore for sorority recruitment video, so I'll put that down below. And the conversation is literally like, what's your major? What did you do over winter break? Where's your hometown? Philanthropy round is on Sunday. You see a couple less chapters and spend a little bit more time. And in all the chapters I went to, I'm pretty sure I saw the National Philanthropies video. Some girls had testimonials if the philanthropy had like a personal impact on them, and then there are some with like crafts, and the conversations are kind of geared towards philanthropy. That round you wear like casual but still cute. The next weekend, Friday, you have sisterhood round, and you had to wait all week to find out which ones you got called back to or cut from. You wear like a casual dress or like a skirt and a top. The conversation was revolving around like what sisterhood events you do, what the sorority means to you, date parties, stuff like that. You just talk about like the events that you host. Also during this round, you see the recruitment video, and you can see recruitment videos on YouTube. A lot of chapters post them, so if you're interested in one, you can check it out. Just a super cheesy video of like all the members like smiling and holding hands. Sisterhood round is when I met my big. A big is the girl typically in the grade above you that's supposed to be like your big sister in the sorority. Saturday was preference round. I think all schools you see 3 chapters and you're there for a really long time, but a lot of the sororities will have like testimonials, a big little pairs, best friends in the sorority. At my school, they all write out like a letter from people that you've met in previous rounds about what they liked about you, what your conversation was, just to like remind you that they like remember you, I guess. And then at the end of pref round on that Saturday night, we went in and put our ranking of the pref order. So what happens with cutting and ranking between each round? You're cutting people and then the sororities are cutting you. I would say that the sororities have more weight for which ones you're going back to, because if they cut you, you're not going back. If you get called back to every single chapter, then your ranking is very important. But if you didn't get called back to some of the chapters you wanted to go back to, you will go back to some of the ones that you cut. Now that we have like a basic understanding of what rush is like, I'll tell you about my experience. To be truthful, I did not like rush. I loved the conversations. When I went to each chapter, I loved the energy. Everyone was so excited, and I loved that. The fact that like people are cutting and ranking you, it can bring out some weird colors in people, making people feel really insecure, making people feel really superior. When you're going through rush, I think it's hard to really trust the system, and that's such a cliche thing to say, but it's so true. And I think in rush respect, you will be so happy with the one that you end up with. So just act authentic to you. I feel like I'm not an overly emotional person. I didn't expect to be so emotional through rush. Just don't take it too personally when you get cut. It's okay, it'll all work out for the best. I remember philanthropy rounds, I found a chapter that I really loved and I was excited to go back for sisterhood, and I actually didn't get called back for sisterhood, but one of my best friends is in there, so I'm not saying that it's not an awesome sorority. Looking back, I don't think I see myself in there as like my home, I guess. Everything works out for a reason. I knew a girl from my rush group, and on bid day she was saying that she really regretted the one that she prepped. I saw her a couple weeks later and she was super happy with her decision. And another girl I knew on bid day, she she prepped one sorority, but she didn't get that one. She got her second choice, but she's so happy with the one she ended up with. Huge advice for you is to not go or like a certain sorority just based on what other people are saying, what your best friends like. My freshman roommate and I are really close and we had some of the same chapters. That definitely made me feel like I liked certain chapters more than others. Like, once again, looking back, I don't see myself in that chapter, the one that she really, really wanted. Just go with the one that in your gut you like. I had always liked Gamma Phi, and like I said, I met my big sisterhood round. I talked to her again in pref round. She was a big reason why I picked Gamma Phi. And another huge tip of mine is to pay attention to the girls that are in line during pref and even sisterhood round, because those are the girls that could be in your pledge class. Those are the people that you could be best friends with in your sorority. Every sorority will have a general vibe to it, but each pledge class has a little bit of variation. I was really in between two sororities, Gamma Phi and another, and the one that I didn't go with, I didn't see myself really being best friends with the girls that were in line with me. But in Gamma Phi, I remember talking to like three girls, and it wasn't like forced conversation. It was just something random that we were talking about, but it was super natural. On bid day, I was even crossing my fingers that I was gonna get Gamma Phi on my bid day card, and I did. So as always, if you have any questions, you can leave me a comment or Snapchat me. Follow me on Instagram if you want to see some pics from me at college and sorority life and stuff like that. Thanks so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.